Hi friends, have all a nice evening. Today I'm going for the second lock out of quiz challenge lockbox here, and I've decided earlier to give the lock from Pickaholic a try, as I've probably never had a challenge lock from him before. I didn't touch it so far. The only thing which I did was reinstalling the pin which holds this end piece in, because it did fall out of his back actually. I have no idea how it was installed, but all is nice and locked again, nice in place. You can see it maybe, just a little bit of play, it already wants to come out again. I hope the lock doesn't fall apart when I try it. There's a nasty pin in the front, which I can already see. It's probably hard to see on the slide, but it has a pretty wide groove in it. The key is mummied. It's a Broncos key, a little design key here. And it is called Spool Me Once. Very, very cool. I like spools. I might be looking forward to it. Okay, let's get the vise in and the lock holder. Yeah, it's a bit big, but it does fit. Okay. Look at the kiwi. Okay. I'll probably go back to my trusty tone pick. I'm trying to use commercial picks when I can. Because I knew many of you can get them. Okay, let's see. We are nicely in frame. I can see pretty much nothing here around the camera. Okay, I probably will go this way. Oh, Kiwi is very wide. I have some taped. It's a bit better. I think I will try this. Okay, it's still a bit loose, but it seems to work. And I will try to pick from this ledge. Let's count the pins. Okay, seem to be 6 pins. This time I'm counting, not like last time. Okay. A little click from one. Okay, two gives a bit of count rotation, and here it's already set. Three. Oh, a little give. Four. Again, a little bit of count rotation. Goes very nicely. Number five. I think I lost something in the front, but I. Okay, want to go all the way down. Okay, let's start again from number one. Okay, a little give from something. I'm not that sure if I'm on the tension wrench here or on a pin. Actually, let's take a look. I might be there on a pin. It feels solid. Two is okay. Three, a little give. Feels okay. 4. 5 feels solid. Again 6. So let's check 1 without pushing the tension wrench out. I have almost no tension on the tension wrench. Okay. 2, a little give. There might be a little bit more. I'm not too sure. As I said, this is my first try on it. The backhand feels really, really loose. Give one another go. Okay. 2, 3. Okay. Number 4 is down. And gives counter rotation. Okay. Now I have a bit more tension on. Yeah, the rest of the lock is still very springy. 1 seems okay. I dropped something again. 2, three four. Maybe the pick is not deep enough. There's a lot of clicking going on. There's no here. Yeah, it was a little bit okay. I think it was pin 3, now pin 4. Counter rotation, okay, the fall set got deeper, and then again already almost losing the tension range here. 5 feels solid. Okay, let's go to the front. Not sure on 1. Okay, 2. 3. 4, a little give. And, okay, counter rotation on 4. Come on. I might have to help it a bit. Okay, but I lost something here in the front. Okay, got it back. Ah, and here it's open. Wow. Wow, this is a really interesting pick. I expected a little bit different from a spool me once. There was counter rotation, but wow, really, really nice. I'm very curious what's inside. As I said, I've probably never picked a lock from Pickaholic. Yeah, really a pleasure. And as I said, this was my first try. Maybe when I pick it more often, I will develop a little feel for it. Let's get some tools in here. And the pinning tray. If you noticed, you like the padlock pinning tray. This is only a prototype. I've never done a second one. Because this edge here lifted up and the design was a bit messed. So let's see if my tool will fit this time. Okay, looks good. Very nice. I will hold this here. Okay, here's a retaining pin and a little spring. Pins are to the front. So let's shim it. Okay. Shim doesn't want to go all the way. Let's try the other side. Maybe this is enough. I will try it. Okay. Okay, went a little bit deeper. I think this is okay. I think it was a 6-pin lock. I'm not 100% sure. So let's see how it goes. No, it is a 5-pin. So I was wrong again. Wow, one surprise after the other. Pins are nicely down. And I can already see. This one seems to be reduced in diameter on the top here. Let's unpack the key first. I'm very curious. Okay, it's wrapped here in this tape. Okay. A bit sticky, but no problem. Very nice fitting, wow. And a little bit dirty from the tape. Very cool. I like the blue color of this key. Blue is one of my favorite ones and matches very nice with orange. Very cool. I want to check. Goes very nicely in here. I can see some crazy nasty rims here. Okay, we will maybe try the lock when I've we assembled it later. Okay, let's dump the pins out quickly. Okay. Oh, I can see very nicely made pins. very cool serrations. And yeah, the first chamber and the third are threaded. Yeah, 2, 4, and 5 are smooth. Very nice. It's a range of pins. Very cool. The first one looks like a spool, and the second one, okay, has 2 serrations. Very nice. I have to look a bit closer on them through the camera display here. And the last one is a T-pin, or a reduced diameter pin here. I still don't know why I counted 6 pins at the beginning. Yeah, even it says 5 on the font. Very nice, let's check. There should be some more spools inside, and the first one is one. Okay, let's get the springs out. A little spring, probably it looks like a brass spring. The second one is a T-pin. Oh, a T-pin spool. Very cool. I really like them. Makes it a bit harder. Okay, let's check the third pin. Oh, I thought it would be a spool, but it is a spool and a serrated together. Very nice. Let's get the spring out here. A little copper spring, so this one is different. And again, a T-pin spool. Oh, it is not a T-pin spool. I have to hold it horizontally. It is. It was this way in. It is a pin and pin with a T-pin end here. Hope you can see this a bit. Oh, you cannot. the little end is sticking out, acting as a T-pin. Very nice. And very, very good made. Yeah, looks fantastic. And the last pin is looks almost like an American spool. With serrations in the thicker end. Maybe it's homemade, I don't know exactly. Okay. Oh, and even the Bible is threaded in 1 and 2. Okay, you can't see again. Sorry. Hope it will focus at some point. But you can see the serrations in 1 and 2. Very nice. Okay. So well done, Pickaholic. Here you can see the key pins again. We'll try to leave them a bit diagonally. Here we have 1 serration on key pin number 3, a double serration on 2, and a very, very nice and deep spool on key pin 1. Yep, we have a spool in 1, a T-pin spool, check, yeah, it's a solid T-pin spool, and 2. We have this spool serrated, pretty long, and we have this pin and pin spool with the end sticking out as a T-pin. Not that easy to do one-handed here, but it works. And we have this American type serrated spool here in the last pin. Very good. Let's quickly check how effective these are. Yeah, definitely the first one is catching very, very nice in the serrations. Okay, let's see. Oh, the spool. Very nice, deeply sitting in, and 1, 2 again. The spool is good active, and also a T-pin here. On the third one, expect, oh, even the serration here might come into play. A little bit, not too much, but a little bit. a very cool pin. I really like this. This is really great. And the worm is catching a little bit on this. These bottom serrations here. Then the T-pin spool. You can see how it is sticking out. So the rest is acting as a T-pin. Very well made. Wow. And they are all effective. Very good. But the last one, there's only the there's only the serration active. Very nice. Okay. Okay, one last thing. Of course, I did forget to show you that the key works. I've just reassembled the lock. So now let's try it out. Okay. There's a little hang in the middle. Let's do it carefully. Okay, yeah. Ah, but it does work. Yeah, I might try to screw it back and a little bit tighter. Sometimes this helps when the lock core is too tight. This is too tight, definitely. Okay, definitely it works. Once you get over this point with a T-pin. Yeah. Wow, very nice. Thank you for making this great lock, Pickaholic. It was very cool to pick, and see you. Bye bye.